Hey YouTube, it's Joelle. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be reviewing a new cream contour and highlighting palette from NYX. By the way, if you notice that I look the exact same way from a few videos coming up this week, it's because it's the same day. I just feel like, I don't know. Do I really need to look that different? You don't really care about how I look, right? Or maybe you do. Maybe you do. Maybe just a little bit. Anyway. So yeah, we're going to... I don't know what that was. We're going to talk about this palette. First, when you open it up, you're going to notice I've already opened it up a little bit, but I tried to keep the sanctity to explain what this is to you. So when you open it up, you can notice there's a actual sealed plastic. So it tries to keep the moisture in. So when you open it up, it's actually taped all the way through. It's not just some random piece of plastic. It's actually sealed. So now that I've taken out the plastic, this is what the product looks like. We got a cream contour over here, a cream highlight here, and a cream shimmer highlight. And I got it in the color light. I did notice that it came in medium and deep. The medium did not look good for contouring. The deep was really beautiful. It was, you know, cool colors. And it was really pretty. Over here we have the contour, the shimmer highlight. That is a hard swatch. A hard swatch. And this is the yellow highlight. And it's supposed to be the regular matte highlight that you put all around your face. I'm gonna blend these. So you can definitely shear out that shimmer highlight. As you can see, it's right here. As opposed to this matte highlight. You can see the difference. Yeah. And blending this contour, you see it's sheer and it's not too warm, but it's not too cool either. So it's really nice. What I will say is that this cream contouring palette is a little more stiff than your conventional cream contour palettes out on the market. Now, apparently, when you use cream contour palettes, they have to be a little stiff because you don't want your cream contour to be too heavy, and then in effect, they're going to be harder to blend out. If you have too much product on, it's gonna be really hard to blend that out. If you have problems using this cream contour palette, you should use a stiffer brush. This is the e.l.f. contouring brush, and it's just a nice, stiff, straight little brush that's flat on the end, and it's really easy and stiff to pick up product. So I'm going to show you right now. As you can see, that wasn't too hard. I'm going to try it with the highlighting colors. What you're gonna wanna do is take a stiff foundation brush and use that with this. Don't be afraid to dig in, okay? And that is the color right there. Now I will say for my skin tone, I don't think that this yellow highlight will necessarily work on most areas of my face, other than maybe the bridge of my nose, but I'm gonna show you what this looks like. If you don't want to have to dig too hard, you can use an oil. This is the Oilless Oil. It's 100% purified squalene from Peter Thomas Roth, and what you can do is you can just add a little oil over here into your contouring palette to like soften up the product. You don't need to use this specific oil. You can choose jojoba or argan oil, anything that's non-comedogenic, and it'll be absolutely fine. As you can see, the product is now easier to work with. I just broke my brush. Oh my god. I just broke my brush. Panic mode. As you can see, it's a lot creamier and easier to work with. I just made it all around my hand. So in the process of doing this, my brush broke. So we're gonna use this contour shade on my cheek now. There you go. So as you can see, my cheek is more defined than this one. This wasn't too hard to blend actually, and with the oil, it definitely helped. Now we're gonna try to clean this up with the yellow because it's kind of hard to do this through a viewfinder. I'm gonna use my foundation brush. I'm just going to clean that up. Right there. I'm gonna try to blend that out. This is an easy trick to sharpen your contour. We're gonna take the Beauty Blender to sort of blend those lines together. This is to ensure that we don't have any harsh lines. And so yeah, this is the highlight and this is the contour. Okay, this looks a lot better than it did when I was playing with this, actually. So I might actually keep this. So that's your contour. It's very harsh, but obviously you're not gonna leave it like that. You would normally set it, put some blush over it, or a little bronzer to sort of round everything out, and then put a highlight. So that's a pretty nice contour, I would say. Well, let's see the highlight over here. This is very intense. Okay, this is very, very highlighted. To the point where I'm not sure I would wear this like this. Or I would wear this under foundation, guys. Definitely under foundation. Because look at my skin tone. Look at how different that is. And that's not necessarily the greatest. I'm gonna try this on my bridge to show you what it looks like. The bridge of my nose. My bridge. Did it just say my bridge? Okay. Tops of the forehead, sure. It doesn't look too crazy over there. And then we're going to contour the sides of the nose. This brush, by the way, makes it so easy to contour the sides of the nose. And you can just go up and down to blend that. And then to go down the nose, I'm going to use my Beauty Blender. So I really didn't think that I would end up liking this. Honestly, I was playing with it the other day and it just seemed so, I don't know, rough. Or maybe it was just the foundation I was using. But honestly, I do like it. Now, this shimmer highlight, of course, we're gonna play with that. This is what it looks like. It's just a very standard shimmer highlight. I use my finger to do this because it's a cream. I am running out of brushes to use. You can also use a foundation brush for this. Or a smaller brush to stipple this on. So it's a very subtle highlight. Nothing I would use to like give you that insane glow, but you can definitely tell it's a glowin'. So overall, this cream contour palette is a mixed bag. I would say that the yellow is too light for my skin tone. I can use it for my forehead and down the bridge of my nose, but that's pretty much about it. I wouldn't use it for huge planes of my face. I feel like it looks a little unnatural and I would have to go over my face with bronzer, so I could play with that and see what that looks like. And then the shimmer highlight is actually really nice. It's a very subtle highlight, definitely. And the contour is my favorite out of this palette. It's a very nice, cool contour. And you can build this entire palette up with a little bit of oil, like argan oil, jojoba oil, or the squalene oil, I don't know how to pronounce that. But if you put that in, you mix it in with that, and you get a more intense look with your contour palette. So this definitely might not be as creamy. It's a lot more stiff than the regular contour palettes that are out in the mass market. So the ABH palette that everybody's in love with, I tried to swatch it. It's very creamy. I don't necessarily like the colors, but it is a lot more easy to work with compared to this palette. But I do think that the stiffness can be fixed with just oil, you know what I mean? So definitely go try this out. See if it works for you. Let me know down below what you guys think. Don't forget to like this video and of course subscribe if you haven't already. All right guys, that's it for today. Bye YouTube.